shooting at me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, okay. Alright, tell me if I see you, just to hang out by here, see you right here. So, yeah, you good? You good?
This lady's trying to get out. Do you mind if I...
Okay.
Still watch your YouTube channel.
Thank you. Yeah, it's kind of far from here.
Good morning, sir. If you could, please tell us your name, spell your last name, and your position.
Yes, my name is Manny Del Toro. Last name is D-E-L-T-O-R-O, and I'm the captain here at Southeastern Division.
Thank you, sir. Can you tell us what happened this morning?
Yes, here in the 5300 block of Lenox at 6:42 hours, we ended up getting a call from a family member of a female who resides here. The issue was the female in the house said that her husband had a gun, was walking around the house, wouldn't let her leave, and she was trapped in the room. And she called a family member. Family member called 911, and that's what brought us here to respond.
And it ended up being a hostage situation?
Yes, initially we had a hostage situation. We made contact with the female inside the house. She said that she was inside a chair. The gentleman was her husband, an 80-year-old male, and he was forcing her to sit in a chair and not allowing her to leave. And he was walking out with a gun. At several times that he came out to the door, the gun was in hand, visible to the officers, and then he went back inside.
Now, we understand he's elderly and maybe suffering from dementia. Do we think that's the case this morning?
Yes, we later learned that this man, he was missing for several days. He was returned home yesterday or early this morning, and he came back here, and he had these delusions that there were people after him. The wife said he did suffer from dementia in and out, but today he was convinced that somebody was out to kill him, and he displayed that behavior today.
Okay, so he did surrender peacefully.
Yes, luckily, after about 30 minutes, he did let the wife out. Once we let the wife out, that was a big sigh of relief. So now we just had a man holding the gun inside. Several times he came to the door, refused to come out. Once our emergency negotiation teams come out here, they were able to establish rapport. And ultimately, he came out right around 8 o'clock and surrendered peacefully.
Now, you said he was missing for several days. Did the department find him?
Yes, he was found by members of our department and returned home. At that time, he didn't display any type of violent behavior, so they were just returning the gentleman to his wife. And which was the case here, when he came out, he was joking around with us and very friendly, so we could see him coming in and out of his mental illness.
Right, and we understand that in the house are a lot of weapons.
Yes, there was at least one weapon in there. The wife said that she knew of two others. Officers are in there clearing the house for weapons now. We have taken weapons from this residence before, and we are definitely going to try to get him the help that he needs and recover all the weapons so that this doesn't happen again.
Okay, so will he be facing any charges?
At this time, we have domestic violence detectives up there evaluating at this time. The big thing will be what his state of mind was, so that'll be the issue. He may face charges, but at this time, our psychological emergency response team is evaluating him and addressing the mental health issue for now.
Well, the family was extremely relieved on how your department handled it.
Well, yeah, we were very very grateful. The big thing is that, you know, it ended up peacefully. The big thing is that we just wanted to de-escalate as much as possible. Luckily, he ended up being compliant at the end. The family members were very, very helpful. They were bringing information that was relevant. We learned he was hard of hearing. We learned he had dementia issues. We knew he had a military background. So we all used those to try to establish some kind of rapport. And ultimately, he came out, and surprisingly, he was joking around with the officers who were taking him into custody.
Anything you'd like to add, sir?
I just want to say that I'm very proud of the young officers. We had a lot of different units in play here. We had a SWAT team did roll out. We had our canine units. We had our PERT team, and you know, all working together, and ultimately our emergency negotiation team were able to talk him down, and we definitely were happy that it ended peacefully.
Sir, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much.